Hi children, welcome back. Okay, in this video we are going to discuss about a new topic, that is clothes that we wear. Okay, we know that what is clothes. Okay, what are the clothes and how different type of clothes we have, different colors we have. Among them, many are our favorites. Isn't it? Some favorite colors are there, some favorite cloth quality will be there, and we are going to wear the different types of the cloths. Then, for what we are using the cloths? Why we have to wear the cloths? Anybody answer? Okay, just to think. Cloths we use to cover our body. Cloths are going to cover our body. Then the cloths are going to protect our body from the heat, from the sun heat and the cold when it is winter, and from the cold when it is rainy season, from the rain and the dust. See, just to assume if there is no cloth on our body, what is going to happen? We are going to get direct all these effects, the heat, cold, rain and the dust. To protect our body, first one is to cover our body. First we have to cover our body. We use cloths. Then cloths are going to protect our body from the heat, cold and rain and the dust. So like this the cloths are very much important. I hope you have understood why do we use the cloths. Then from where do we get the cloths? Any idea children for you? Yes, of course. We get the cloths from, there are some sources, okay. For example, from the cotton. First one is from the cotton. Then we get some type of cloths, that is wool. And some type of cloths, that is silk. And then leather. Last one is leather. We know that cotton will come from plants. And wool will come from the animals. The silk will come from a small worm is there, silkworm. The silk is going to come from that silkworm. And then leather we get from the animals. Let us see one by one. Cotton, we have the plant. We will get the cotton just like a flower of the plant. After some days or some months, it will get matured. And we are going to remove the cotton. Inside that cotton, there will be seeds. Those seeds are removed. Again, those threads are formed. And then those threads are used for the manufacturing of the fabric. Fabric means the cloth. So like this, we use the cotton. Again, the wool. Wool again from animals, we will get the wool. We will again, we will make a bundle of the wool. And those wools are again designed or again joined to make a sweater, muffler and the scarf, okay, and like shawl. This wool is useful for leather. Then the silk, we know silk, silk sari we have, silk dresses we have. That silk, again that silk will come from the silk worm, okay, that is one type of worm. Then that silk silkworm will give us the silk. Using those silk, again the silk threads are made, and using those threads the silk fabric is manufactured in your factories. Then the leather, we have our sandals, we have our mobile covers, we have our vanity bags, we have our pocket like purses. So these all are made up of leather. Then how do these leather happen? This leather has come. Leather is nothing but the skin of the other animals. For example, skin of the frog, skin of the pig, skin of the buffalo, skin of the snakes, okay, skin of the tortoise, and skin of the crocodile also, and skin of the cheetah. So like this, when those animals die, naturally when they die, we will get the skin out of their body, and that skin is again left to the sunlight, when all the skin will become dry, that skin will be used for the particular manufactures. Like just now, I have told you, belts are made up of skin. Some chappals, that is sandals, are made up of skin, that is leather. And some pockets, purse, vanity bag, bags are made up of leather. So like this, we are preparing or we are using to manufacture different things. In those things, leather is used as the main, main product. So this is how we get these different types. Then, which type of cloths we are going to use? For example, as it is the summer season, which type of cloths we will use, children? Very easy. In the summer season, we are going to use the cotton cloths and the linen cloths, because those cloths will keep our body cold. So in that season, if we use polyester and silk cloth, again those will get again, those will produce more heat, and even outside also more heat will be there. We feel more heat during that summer season if we wear other than cotton and nylon. Okay, then cotton and nylon are used for the summer season. And in the winter season, it will be very cold outside, so we want to protect our body, we want to keep our body very hot, warm, isn't it? To keep our body warm, which type of cloth we should? The cloths which are made by the wool. Then which are the cloths which are made by the wool then? Sweater, muffler, scarf and the shawl, those all are manufactured by using the wool. Especially we use this wool products in the winter season. Then silk. Silk plays a most important role, and it is most precious also, because silk is very costly. Compared to all this, silk is very costly. And we wear silk dresses during some festivals, marriages. Silk saris will be used, silk kurtas, jubba paisams will be used, and you are also going to use the silk cloths. If boy are there, boy type of cloths, and girl is there, girl's type of cloths we are going to use during any special occasion. There must be a festival, or there must be some special big function should be there. So those days we are going to wear very shiny and very nice silk cloths. Then the leather, as I told you, to make the sandals and to make the purses, vanity bags and the bags and the suitcases. And sometime the belt which your father and your brothers will use, even girls also use the belts. So like this, using the skin of other animals, this leather, when we use the skin of other animal when they are dyed, then that is called as the leather. The leather products are many. Okay, we will use like this. In this video, children, we have discussed about what are cloths, for what the cloths are used. And then from where do we get the cloths, we came to know that there are some sources of the cloths, that is first one is cotton, wool, silk and the leather. Again, from where we get the cotton? From the plants. Wool, from where we get the wool? From the animals. Then from where we get the silk? From the silkworm. And from where the leather is coming? From the skin of the other dead animals, like tiger, cheetah, lion, elephant, snake, frog, crocodile, turtle and buffalo. So like this, the skin of like this dead animals we are going to get. I hope you have understood whatever we have discussed, and you can write you can make your match the followings of like five. This side you can write the this like this cotton, wool, silk and leather. This side you can write some products names, then you can match that. So I hope you will do this homework and enjoy this video. Okay, let us meet on next video. Till then, take care. Bye.